Ladies and gentlemen, joining me on the line from the Iowa Events Center, it's our old pal, Chris Connolly. What's going on, Chris? You got anything going on this week?
It's a little busy this week, but good to be with you today.
So the NCAA is making its third men's basketball appearance at the arena this year, correct?
That is correct. We hosted in 2016 and 2019.
Now, coming up this week, Thursday and Saturday are going to be the games, and you guys got some great teams this year and some interesting potential matchups if things go
well. Super excited. Yeah, we feel like we got a great draw. I mean, you take a look at it. We got Kansas as a number one seed. You got Texas as a number two. Penn State, Texas A&M, Illinois, Arkansas. We feel like it's strong, and we feel like the fan bases will travel and come to Des Moines. So really, really excited about the draw that we got.
The one potential matchup I was looking at was if Texas and Texas A&M both move on.
Right.
That could be a throwback to the old Big 12 days.
Yeah, that'd be an awesome second-round matchup. And same thing. I mean, Kansas could either face Illinois or Arkansas in the second round, and that could be a good game too. So we're excited. We feel like we were blessed in terms of the draw that we got again the third time. I think all three have been really strong, so it's good stuff.
Interesting thing about it this year, a little bit later start than past couple years.
It is, yeah. It's a little different. And back in 2019, we were the first game to tip in the entire country on Thursday versus this time around. The first game will tip on Thursday at 1 p.m. Doors to the arena, Wells Fargo Arena, will open at 11:30. And I just, you know, with over 17,000 tickets sold for the event, I just can't stress enough to try and come to the arena and get in the building early. It's going to be busy on Thursday.
Yeah, that's the one thing about this. When you get in there, I mean, it's people are ready to go, and it's a great environment.
No doubt. And I think that's why the NCAA loves coming to Des Moines. I mean, most of the time we're sold out right after the public on sale. But it's a good mix of the school fan bases coming in and then local people that love basketball. I mean, people are in their seats for all the games, all the sessions, and the NCAA really likes that. So we've been fortunate. Third time now a host since 2016, and it's been really, really good.
Chris Connolly from the Iowa Events Center on the line with me right now. Now, not only do the games go on, but I believe there's the open practice. Is it on Wednesday this year?
It is. So the teams will all start traveling into Des Moines tomorrow on Tuesday, and then the open practice will be on Wednesday. All eight teams will practice in Wells Fargo Arena. First practice starts at 11 a.m. Doors to the arena will open at 10 a.m. It is totally free to come in. There is no charge for parking. There's no ticket needed. So it's a free event. So if you have an opportunity to come down, the last two times we've hosted, we've gotten really good crowds. It's exciting. A lot of times the teams are in for the first time in the arena. The fan bases are in for the first time. And it's just a cool atmosphere. And because of the demand's been so high for tickets, it is another avenue to be part of the environment that's going on while the NCAA is here.
It is kind of fun, and I've seen this event the last two times it's been in, and to see the fan bases come in, they run a I know they call it a practice bay, but it's more the teams just coming in and kind of getting used to the building and shooting around and stuff, but it's fun to watch.
Absolutely. Yeah, I mean, it's almost like they each get 40 minutes, and they have the opportunity just to get used to the building and just, you know, get in there and understand what it's about, and then they also meet with the media, and then they'll go practice off-site and, you know, privately, but it's cool. It really is. You get all eight schools. The fan bases are in town and they're excited. You know, and there's also another avenue. On Thursday, if you don't have a ticket to either of the two sessions, we are hosting a fan fest in Hy-Vee Hall, which we've done the two previous times. And that also is no charge to get into the fan fest. And we'll have big screen TV showing all the live action, inflatable games. You'll have food and drink. It's a pretty cool atmosphere. So, again, if you don't have a ticket, that's another avenue to get in that there's no charge for. And that'll be fun on Thursday in between the two sessions.
Chris Connolly on the line, NCAA tournament coming to the Wells Fargo Arena. Everything kind of gets going on Wednesday, technically, but games on Thursday and Saturday. If there's one game on Thursday that you're really looking forward to, which one is it?
Jeez, it's I think, honestly, the Penn State-Texas A&M is a really, really good matchup. I think Kansas on their end, they'll take care of business there with a 16 seed, and Texas should beat Colgate. But I do believe Penn State-Texas A&M will be a great game, and Illinois and Arkansas are evenly matched with an 8-9 seed. So I'd say Illinois-Arkansas, Penn State-Texas A&M. But it's going to be fun. I mean, four college basketball games in one day, it's a long day, but it's a great day. We're all looking forward to it.
Perfect. Chris Connolly on the line with me right now. We'll get all the details over at the website. Chris, good luck to you, and have fun with this week. It is a lot of fun to see what they do to the arena and how it gets set up and just how big and really cool everything looks.
Thank you so much. Really looking forward to it.